Zay here. Yes, he's a freak, but he built his body using ATG principles, full ranges of motion, which then transfers over to being able to do heavy ass freaky things like three plate dips. Get a good range, good range. Push! Come on, come on, squeeze! Yes, sir. That's almost his body weight hanging on top of his own body weight. Nice job, bro.
Yes, sir, thank you.
So, you're not gonna start there, but that shows you the potential of what full range of motion training can do, okay? He's never spent a ton of time doing any partials or anything like this. Not that that's bad or has no point. Again, point of this video and the whole ATG concept is that training full range of motion can get you to where you want strength-wise. Doing a good drop set here. See that full range of motion? You can't do that without that shoulder strength. This, of course, hits the triceps and the chest as well. Good. Very nice. So in this video, I want to talk about a couple technical points on the ATG press. It's really just a proper full range of motion dumbbell shoulder press, okay? So I'm going to show you a little bit of my back here. The key here is that my wrist hands are in line with my ears, okay? This ensures full proper activation of my rotator cuff, but it also just simply transfers over better to other exercises like the behind the neck shoulder press, the snatch, and really allows fullest stretch of those shoulder muscles, okay? So we spend a lot of time already doing bench press, incline press, dips, push-ups, where our arm is in front of our shoulder, okay? We spend a lot of time in this closed position, so we don't need more of that. We wanna balance that. We wanna hit that full range. That's why we spend a lot of time on the upper back and rotators, just to balance all that short range pressing motions, okay? Another thing I like to do with my ATG press is that I like to add a little rotation at the top, okay? So that doesn't mean I move my elbow. It simply means I rotate my wrist. This allows for a little bit more full range engagement, okay? And it hits that tricep. And remember, if you are having problems with dips or push-ups with pain, start light. If you can move your arm with no weight through a full range of motion, granted, if you can do this, you can start. You can use 1 pound, 2 pound, 3 pound, just work your way up. Once you can do about a quarter of your body weight per hand, maybe a little bit less, depending on your age and your body type, but once you can get, I would shoot for about 25% body weight. Once you can do that, you should not have any problems in your dips and pressing, okay? And remember, this is part of a overall program, okay? So obviously the full programs are on the ATG app and all that. You can find that there, but this is not to say that everything else is useless. Of course, we need to attack our rotators. We need to strengthen all the external rotation muscles and things like this. But if you cannot do this ATG shoulder press with 25% of your body weight and you're still having pain, that's a sign. That right there is telling me, well, keep getting stronger there before attempting full range dips, okay? So remember, dips as an exercise are not inherently bad for your shoulders. It simply means that your shoulders, whether it's your rotator cuff or just simply your shoulder strength, is not up to par for your body weight, okay? So there's nothing wrong with this full range of exercise. A lot of people will say, oh, this is bad for your shoulders or it hurts my shoulders. Fine, I'm not saying it doesn't, but it means that you need to improve certain areas. It should not be painful to your shoulders. One of the key ATG principles is we believe in full functional strength of all ranges of motion of your body. You should be able to use all your joints through this entire range of motion without pain, okay? And then a step past that is not only without pain, but actually being strong and athletic, okay? Increasing the ability, as we say, right? Your pain-free ability. So again, the full range of motion allows more use of the triceps, of those shoulder muscles, of your chest. Once you can get here, you're going to really be able to start making a lot more gains, adding a lot more muscle mass. Another exercise that I like as well, which I like to use with a little bit more progressed athletes, okay? So if obviously if you have significant pain in shoulders, I don't recommend this, but once you've been doing the ATG press for, you know, many months and you start to make good progress and you need a little bit of a variation or change, you can use the behind the neck barbell press, okay? So you're gonna get a nice solid close grip here. And similar to that ATG shoulder press, you simply are now using a barbell. You can load a little bit heavier. Again, a lot of people will say, that's bad for your shoulders. I can't do that. Again, that means your rotators are not strong enough, they're imbalanced, or you simply don't have enough shoulder strength. Start earlier. Everything in ATG progresses from body weight, just simply moving your own weight on your arm, to loading, to more advanced, to then Zay level status, doing crazy heavy dips. The full programs, again, are on ATG app, atgonlinecoaching.com. Under the physique tab, there's all sorts of programs ranging from, you know, optimal fat loss to optimal strength gaining, muscle building, things like this. Check it out. I hope they help. You can message me if you have any questions about those programs. And quickly, if you need any sort of your basic supplements, creatine, zinc and magnesium, your minerals for recovering, electrolytes, amino acids, check out serponutrition.com. I have all those there. There's a discount code below in the bio. So I hope that helps you more with your recovery. You get better workouts. If you have any questions, again, let me know. Thank you for watching.